Well, good morning. I'm in Rome, and this is the Pantheon behind me. And the reason I'm in Rome is really exciting. I'm here to meet Jesus. Now, before you jump off your chair and shout at me, not the real Jesus, obviously, but I'm here to interview Jonathan Roumie, who plays Jesus in the TV series called The Chosen. It's a brilliant depiction of the life of Jesus and the disciples. Really brings the gospel stories to life. So some of us who are helping with distribution and marketing have been invited to interview him about why he's doing it, what impact it's had on him, what he thinks the importance and the value of this series are to people like you and me. So, iconic role, what went through your mind when they offered you it?
Yes, please.
Straight, no doubts? No,
not at all. I had worked with the director of the show, the creator, for the previous 4 years. We had done short films together playing Jesus, so I feel like I had a bit of a trial run going into this, and I was a desperately out of work actor and was more than humbled and graced to have the opportunity to reprise the role.
Did you imagine it turning out like this?
Part of me thought that it could happen if it was done right, that this could be like, you know, the biggest thing ever if it was done well. And if, you know, after shooting the first four episodes, like, it was clear that God's hand is on this some way, and I think he wants this to succeed, and it's bringing people to him and bringing souls back, and it's just doing extraordinary work.
Yeah, fantastic. So do you see this as like a destiny element for you in ending up playing the role?
Yeah, I think this will be the thing that I'm remembered for. If there's anything to be remembered for at all, this will be it.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't know how I could do any better than this.
It's an interesting one, isn't it? Because like, how do you top this? But now that you've done this, how do you beat that?
And it's not to say I might not play a character that might become, that might have a greater success in the secular world, or might have bigger box office. Like, who knows? I don't know. But I think because of who Jesus is and the impact he has on people's lives personally, mm-hmm. there's nothing that will ever compare to this.
Yeah.
Yeah. And that's at the end of the day, that's what it's about.
And how did you find the Jesus character that you're playing? Where did that come from?
I mean, it started 5 years before the show. I played Jesus for a film theatrical production about the life of Saint Faustina, a Polish nun in the 1930s, and who had visions of Christ. And I played Christ for 3 days. We filmed up in Washington State for this project. And then 6 months later, I got cast by Dallas Jenkins in a short film that he was doing for his church's Easter service. And we hit it off, and then he asked me back the following year. And then the year after that, he did a different kind of project. And then the year after that, he asked me back again. And then it was about a year and a half later that The Chosen came into being.
So it's obviously it's his writing and then your delivery. But is that just happened, or have you discussed that? Is that controlled? Or?
He's got a writing team. So there's a head writer, Ryan Swanson, and Tyler Thompson is the other writing partner. So there's a triumvirate of sorts that go through developing the entire series, and then each season, prior to shooting the season, writing the episodes, and they run them through a biblical team of consultants just for anything that might be glaring or concerning or disconcerting. Yeah, and then when it gets to shooting it, obviously I'll have ideas about things that I think I connect with, or things I might be challenged by, and we'll have discussions when we need to have discussions, and the rest is our shorthand of working together. And he also trusts me that if there's something that I want or feel compelled to change or say differently, that there's a good reason for it, and you know, he'll give me flexibility there.
That's cool. What do you think Jesus is going to say to you when you get up there and meet him?
Well, I hope he says, not too shabby. I hope he says that that was pretty close, but I doubt it. But you know, he'd be like, maybe it wasn't your thing.
That's good.
So, I mean, you put me here. It's your fault.
You set me up.
Yeah, you set me up.
What's been the most satisfying scene that you've played?
Oh, that's hard. I mean, I've got a bunch of scenes that I love. The the John 3:16 scene playing out with Nicodemus. Any of the stuff I do with Liz Tavish, who plays Mary Magdalene, she's just a wonderful friend and an amazing scene partner. I just love working with her, and a number of the other actors are just super, super talented. It's really hard to whittle it down, but I think the end of the first season, the end of episode 8, and episode, I think it's 7 with Nicodemus, are some of my favorites. And then there's a bunch of stuff in season 2, like at the end of episode 3, season 2, where I'm in it for a very short period of time. To me, was a really fun moment to get to do, because you really see Jesus, his physical exhaustion and the humanity of this situation, the day, and how it's worn on him. In that one, quick little moment. So that was fun to play too.
Yeah. What about your own view of Jesus, as you're portraying him? Has that morphed over time as you've been doing this?
I think it's been filled in a lot of ways by this deeper connection to him. I think it's forced me to rely on him more and to converse more frequently with him, and to want to know more about, just wanting to try to get the portrayal as close to what might have been passable, I think always trying to pine for truth, and what, as an actor and then as a seeker and a follower of Christ, is something that we're always looking for, is just what was the truth about who he was, and then trying to take that and then interpret that on the film.
Yeah, fantastic. Well, huge thank you for what you're doing. I found it inspirational. It's been absolutely brilliant. And thanks for your time too.
Thank you, I appreciate it.
All the best.
Thank you, and you as well.
All the best, mate.
All right, mate.
Jessica.
Oh, that was great. What a lovely guy. I really enjoyed talking to him. Jonathan Roumie is a very, very humble, very sincere man, and he takes this role incredibly seriously. He realizes that God has given him an incredible privilege to play Jesus in a series like The Chosen. The other thing that I really liked is how much effort they put into making it as accessible as possible to as many people as possible, regardless of their denominational backgrounds. So if you're running a small group, or you want to run a small group, or you're a church leader, this is a brilliant resource for you. It's such a good way of affirming the faith of people who are already believers, and it's a fantastic way of introducing seekers to Jesus in a really non-embarrassing, well-made, articulate, funny, warm, sensitive way. So if you haven't already, download the app and start watching the series. And then if you think that's a resource that you'd like to use, then come on to Eden.co.uk and we can help you with the materials that you need.
Okay. Okay.